Hey folks, it's time to ride. Are you ready? No, not there. The steel horse. So we're going to entitle this video, How to Ride Motorcycle for the First Time. Let's get the camera ready. You know, most people, they start off on a motorcycle like this. This is a Ninja 250. And it's got six speeds, it's got a little 250 motor in it, so you can't get yourself into too much trouble. And I'm going to show you some things, and we're also going to take it on little twisties here, and then we're going to take it on the freeway. And I'm going to go through some things that you can do to increase your chances of having a fun ride and not killing yourself, okay? I haven't crashed yet, but it's because I'm a very safe rider. And I drive defensively or ride defensively. If you've never ridden a motorcycle, let me show you some things. On most Japanese bikes, the right side is braking. This is the front brake here, and then that's the rear brake right here. Now, mosey on over here. The left side is mostly, look at the horse is like, come on. Don't you love me anymore? That's not my horse, just some horse where I parked. The left side here is shifting. This is the clutch. And then this is the shift lever. So watch my fingers, okay? Let's say that this is first gear, this is neutral. This is second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth. There's six gears, right? So sixth, fifth, fourth, third, second, neutral, first. First, neutral, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth. Now let's get on it. What you're going to do here is get in the habit when you're new of flipping the switch. This will shut the power to the bike off, okay? So you want to get in the habit in case there's an emergency or something happens or you crash the bike and you want to shut the motor off. You're going to flip this and it'll shut the bike off instantly. So notice we turn it on, turn the key on, but it won't start. You have to put it there and then it starts. So let's go through some of the mistakes people make. I made this mistake of not putting the kickstand up, and then you go to take a corner and you hit it and crash time. So always make sure you put the kickstand up. Let's go through shifting. Okay, I'm going to try to cram as much information into this video as possible. So I'm not going to spend a lot of time with small talk. Let me put this magnetic tank bag here. I'm going to just get right to all the lessons that you need. Some very important things if you're going to be riding is you got to learn how to get the bike going and how to stop it. Those are the basics you want to start with. When it comes to stopping the bike, look at the handlebars. Always try to stop like this. Don't stop like this, or because then you're going to crash. You always want to be straight when you're stopping, which is why I probably never crash, because I'm a conservative. I always stop straight. So now, in order to get this show on the road, we're going to pull the clutch in. We're going to kick down right here. Watch. Let's see if I can show you. Watch. Clutch in. Watch my toe. I'm now in first. See how the neutral light's off? If I slightly kick up, watch the neutral light. See, it's in neutral. So you want to get in the habit of that. Getting into neutral, getting out of neutral. Watch. Clutch in. Notice I'm squeezing the clutch in. Watch the neutral light. Kick down. Neutral light's out. Here's the very important part. You listen, little horsey. The important part is don't just pop this clutch and let it out. You start to let it out slowly, and as soon as you feel it catching, you give it a little bit of throttle. Here's the throttle here, watch. You can keep your feet down until it starts going. Notice we're in gear, I let go of the clutch. Now when you're coming up to a stop sign, I like this part because no one's here. Clutch in, brake, and make sure, you know, you get in the habit of putting your left foot down, because the brakes are all here on the right. So your rear brake's here too. So get in the habit of kind of leaning a little bit and coming to a stop and putting your left foot down. You notice I'm still in first. I'm just holding the clutch lever. So now if I want to go, again, make sure there's no cars, obviously. Now we're in first. This is a great road to practice on. Notice no one's here. Clutch in, kick up, release, and now I'm in second. We're going to go up to third. Clutch in, kick up, clutch in, kick up, release. Now we're in third. Now you want to keep your eyes ahead. Don't be doing like what I'm doing. I'm just showing you. Watch. Clutch in, kick up. Now I'm in third. We're going to clutch in, kick up, and now we're in fourth. Clutch in, kick up, now we're in fifth. It's got six gears. Clutch in, kick up. I was already in sixth. All right, so pavement ends. So now let's do downshifting. You slow down, clutch in, kick down. Look at the tack, it's at 3,000. That's a good place to downshift. Watch the neutral light. I'm constantly kicking down. Now I'm in neutral. Notice I'm in neutral. I'm on a hill that's going like this, right? So clutch in, kick down, and here's how you hold yourself on a hill. See, if I let go, I start rolling back. So see, I'm using the brake. You let go of the clutch, and you'll feel it engaging. See that? Watch the tack. See how it's adjusting? As soon as you feel it engaging, slowly give it throttle while I keep releasing the clutch lever. So we have a dirt road here, so we're going to turn around. So clutch in, I have my left foot down here. Notice I'm slowly walking it. Now I'm in first, slowly going downhill. See this? Now, going downhill, no one's behind me. Look at all this road we have. We're going to go around some twisties here and we'll get on the freeway. Clutch in, kick up to second. Remember what I told you about stopping. Keep the bike straight. Clutch in, kick up to third. Beautiful day today. So that's some of the mistakes people make, clutch in, kick up to fourth, is they stop, and when you're coming to a stop, the bike, the handlebars are a little crooked, and all the weight of the bike shifts. Even the 250 will actually tip over, you know, because it's not like 50 pounds, it's hundreds of pounds, so you're going to tip the bike over if you're not stopping correctly like this. Okay, so now let's practice stopping. So I'm going to go all the way up to sixth. I'm in sixth. We got a stop sign here, so watch. This is how you want to stop. You want to get in the habit of stopping like this. So as you're approaching, I'm going to go to fifth. Watch. Clutch in, kick down to fifth. I release the clutch. Notice I'm slowing down. Now I start braking. Clutch in, kick down to fourth. You want to be in like second when you're almost ready to stop, and there's where the horse was. Clutch in, kick down, and now, see, I'm in neutral. See how the handlebars are straight. Okay, now let's talk about counter steering. Clutch in, kick down, we're in first. Now we're going to get on a little bit more speed, and we'll show you how to take off. Not, you know, super fast, but a little more advanced. Release the clutch lever, give it throttle. Clutch in, kick up to second. Clutch in, kick up to third. Clutch in, kick up to fourth. Clutch in, kick up to fifth. So, let's see, we have a 20 mile per hour, 30 mile per hour, no 20, yeah, I'm right. 20 mile per hour corner here. Going about 40. And now we're going to take this corner. Clutch in, and I'm up in sixth, up to sixth. Counter steering is this. Well, counter steering is we have a corner to the right coming up here. So I'm going to pull this handlebar towards me. The left handlebar is going to move towards me. And watch what it does when I slightly do it. See how it's moving me in the right lane? Well, that's what it's going to do around this corner. So I want to get some speed so I can show you. And it's basically counter pressure. I'm going to pull it back and hold it. Here it goes. Watch out, watch the steering. Watch the handlebars. See how it's doing it? I'm pulling back this way. Now let's do some freeway driving. What do you think? Another thing too, we've got a stop sign here. Watch. Braking, clutch in, kick down to fifth, release. I'm still in fifth. Clutch in, kick down to fourth, third. I skipped the third, release. Clutch in, I'm now in first gear, stop. See how we did that? Release the clutch, give it throttle. Second. Third. Fourth. Fifth. Sixth. You want to make sure that your tire pressure, this is a major thing with motorcycle riding. So much is riding on your tires. On a motorcycle, the tire pressure is like 50 times more important than the tire pressure on a car. If you're in a car and you have, hold on a second, clutch in, kick down to fifth. Notice I'm in fifth still going, clutch in, now I'm just kicking down, I'm not releasing the clutch, I'm in neutral. See that? It's another little way you can do it if you have to do these like panic stops. But in a car, you can have low tire pressure. Big deal, right? You'll get bad gas mileage. You won't really notice it that much unless you're going on long trips. You'll notice the gas mileage isn't that good. But on a motorcycle, wow, you can feel every little difference in tire pressure. Okay, here we go. Second. Watch. Clutch in third. Clutch in fourth. So, clutch in fifth. You're going to notice that it doesn't handle as well. Sometimes it'll, like, float across the lanes. You really always want to check your tire pressure. It's good to get like a digital tire pressure read, and you want to check your tire pressure in the morning when it's not hot, when you haven't ridden on the tire pressure, you'll get a more accurate reading. On the sidewall of the motorcycle tire, it'll tell you what the PSI is. Like it'll say maximum PSI 35, for example. By the way, counter steering here. And so you want to make sure your tire pressure is always monitored. All right, so we're going to be getting on the freeway here. We got the green. Don't forget to click below this video, and I did a video where I'm riding a 600, and we compare the differences between a 600 and a 250 as far as which one you should start off with. All right, we're going to talk to you about freeway riding now as we approach, but we're in sixth, clutch in, I'm going to go fifth, fourth, because see the tack's down at $2,000. Now we're going to clutch in, release third, clutch in twice, slightly to neutral. See how I did that? When you click slightly down from second, you'll go into neutral on the Ninja 250. Okay, on the freeway, speed is life. You want to be going as fast as the cars or faster. You don't want to be going slower than the cars, okay? This is just my opinion. The reason why is if you're alongside the car, you're going the same speed as the cars. This is how you get hit. You always want to be able to be moving where you can get out of the way of the car. And I'm a car driver also, but I want to tell you, when you're a motorcycle rider, you have a lot more respect for motorcycle riders when you're a car driver, you realize really how people don't watch out for them. Now, sometimes when I stop, I'll go like this if I see cars coming up behind me, because if the guy's going to not be able to stop in time, I can go to the left and he'll just crash into the car in front of me, but he won't crash into me. So, now we're going to be getting on the freeway here, and I'm going to show you how I drive on the freeway. I like to go faster than the vehicles. I stay away from the vehicles. I don't want to be around the vehicles. Don't ride on a motorcycle, it's my opinion, like how you drive in a car where you just cruise alongside the car next to you. It's just Russian roulette. You're going to basically get crashed into if you do that. You ever wonder why us motorcycle guys and gals are always going faster than the other cars? There's a reason. You drive alongside, you're going to get squished. So if you're not able to ride alongside the cars, just stay away from them, okay? So we're going to be getting on the freeway here, and then I'm going to see if I have time to take this motorcycle into the twisties. If you are getting a Ninja 250 and you're going to be going on the freeway, for heaven's sake, get a different sprocket. You know, tell the guy that's going to put the sprocket in that you want to do freeway riding and you don't want the tach always to be up at 9,000, 10,000 on the tach. You're not going to get good gas mileage this way. You want to be able to go, at least in California, you want to be able to go 80 where the tach's not going through the roof. Now, this is a little 250. Notice it starts to redline at 13,000. I'm going to show you where it's at on the freeway going the speed limit. Now, it says 65. Everyone here goes 75 on the freeway that I'm going to be going to. That's just the reality of the situation. But I'm going to go at the speed that the cars are at. Watch, kick down first. Kick up to second. Kick up to third. Let's get on it. Fourth. Fifth. Now we're at 8,000 on the tach. We're in fifth, okay? We're going 60. Not bad for a 250. Kick up six. But this is what I wanted to show you. The tach shows 80. There's no way we're going 80. But notice it says 10 grand on the tach. Now it's almost 11 grand. So if you want to test the accuracy of your speedometer, look, it says like 80. There's no way. What you do is, why is this guy braking and there's absolutely no one in front of him? What you do is you get someone alongside of you in a car and you have them say, look, I want you to go at 65, for example, and then you go at 65. And if you're going slower than the car, then you know your speedometer is not accurate. Now, I know what you're saying. Well, what if the car's not accurate? It does create issues. Now, in California, you can go in the carpool lane, which is awesome. So notice I'm not around vehicles. I don't want to be next to the vehicle. Watch, I'm going to pass the vehicle. You either want to pass the vehicle, stay behind the vehicle. When they're coming on like this, get over. Please, don't stay next to the vehicle. Another thing too is, let's talk about your gear. You want to have gear where you have knuckle protection. When it's real hot, like I have, hey look, there's a motorcycle rider here. I have a jacket on right now with CE Armor in it. But I'm going to show you something. If you look real close, there's like a waffle design. So the air kind of goes through it. Let's see what this guy's in on. Notice he doesn't have a windscreen. Oh, I hate that. He's got like a skull mask. Now you see how, let's talk about that. You see how he didn't have a full face helmet? I'm not going to judge people that don't have a full face helmet, because there is something wonderful about the sun in your face, the air. I've ridden a motorcycle with shorts and a tank top before, you know, going down to the beach, and I wouldn't do that if I was new, but sometimes I'll do that, you know. It's just awesome when it's real hot out, and you know, if you're going to crash, you're basically doomed. But even when I had shorts on and stuff, I made sure that I had a full face helmet, because those bugs hurt. Those bugs absolutely hurt. All right. So now what we're going to do, we talked to you about gear, you know, get good gloves. If you're in an area that's really hot, you can get a jacket like this. See how there's little holes in it, yet there's armor. I don't know if you can see the elbow here and my shoulders. I don't know if you can see that. So at least it does something if you crash. Now, getting off here, I'm not putting the brake on. We're in sixth gear. The bike's basically slowing itself down, and this bike just handles totally awesome. It cuts through the corners. It's great. You'll see these 250s at the track, and also people will take them up to the mountains. Okay, downshifting. Now look, I'm coming around the corner. Look at, notice I'm trying to hold the handlebars as straight as possible when I'm coming around the corner to a stop. So here we go. Second gear. Third gear. Why is this guy pulling over? Maybe he wants me to go? Yeah. Let's see, yep, that was nice of them, getting out of the way. You want to have high top shoes. You want to have where your ankles are protected. Now, looks like we got a motorcycle rider in front of us. See if I can catch up to him. He's got the red light. I want to tell you something, another thing, kind of embarrassing, but I want to tell the new riders, if you're not used to riding, sometimes your rear end is going to hurt. So one of the things, oh, that guy turned off way up there. One of the things you can do is wear sweats. You wear some sweats underneath your pants till your rear end gets used to it. A lot of new motorcycle riders like, oh my gosh, you know, they got monkey butt hurt syndrome. Get some sweats, one or two pairs, and it adds like a little cushion, and you'll enjoy the ride much better. Your rear end doesn't get so sore. Now what we're going to do, we're going to do some counter steering. Higher speed limit here, 55. What the heck? All right. If you're a new rider and you're going into the corners, make sure you don't take the corner, you don't approach it too fast where you got to slow down. you will not be able to slow down going around that corner without risking serious bodily injury to your person. You want to make sure that you time the corner correctly. Now we have a sharp, semi-sharp corner here. I'm going to pull towards me with this left handlebar towards my ribcage. This is the type of video you guys wanted to see. Now, another one here. As you can see, the 250 just handles phenomenally. This is like nothing. You could throw the toughest curves at it. This is like nothing. Not that this is tough, but it just does these corners with ease. Now, if you ride where it's very cold, you can go to the sporting goods store and they got these little packets and you shake them up and they get real hot. I mean, burning hot. And you can put them in your gloves, you put them in your pockets where you're toasty warm. What about if you ride in the rain? They say it's not good for your visor, but I've done it. I've just put Rain-X right here. Excuse me. And the water just beads down the windscreen. All right, we're coming up to a stop sign and then we're gonna go through some windy corners. One way you take the corner, see, I'm gonna go the right, you go left, and then you cut right. Not that this is the hard corner, but you're always straightening out the corners. Now, let's practice stopping. If you're new, you wanna practice stopping, stopping, stopping. If you ever get into trouble, hold the clutch in. If you start panicking, hold the clutch in and stop. Now watch, we're starting to brake, clutch in, kick down, fifth, fourth, release. Notice I skipped a gear or two. Kick down, all the way down to neutral. Now I'm in neutral. Here we go. The shifting's pretty easy, guys, once you get it going, okay? You're gonna do great shifting. Some people will say they're having a hard time getting across a crosswalk before they even got to shift gears. It's just probably because of the way your bike is. The 250 is the same way. First gear on the 250 is literally just to get the bike moving. Once it's moving, you can immediately go up into second gear. I'll show you at this next stop sign. So some bikes are like that. If you drive a 600, those bikes, you usually can make it all the way across the intersection without having to shift upward. Talk about helmets. Get a helmet which is not too tight and not too loose. What you want to do is move the helmet around. If your skin from your skull moves with your helmet, that's a good size. You want your skin on your scalp to move, I should say. Now watch how first on the 250 is basically just to get the bike going. We're going to let this person go first. Watch. I'm just going to get it going a little, and then we'll go up to the second. Watch. First, it's going. Now I'm up to second. See that? That's really all it's for. Now I'm up to third. So you got stopping and shifting. It's pretty easy. You guys get the idea. You shift into the gear you want with the clutch, hold the clutch lever in. Once the gear's on your foot, once you've kicked it into gear, you release. Don't release it like that, you release it smoothly. Once you're in second or third, then you can release a little bit faster. But starting off, you release it smoothly. Once you got the bike going, you can go a little bit faster. We learned that the shifting is like a ladder. Watch my, hold on a second. Watch my pinky's first gear. Hold on, let me take the corner. As you get more experience, you take the corner with one hand. My pinky's first gear, this finger right by my pinky is neutral, middle finger's third, this finger's fourth, and the thumb's fifth, and there's another gear even after the thumb. So if I'm in sixth gear, I can kick down to fifth, fourth, third, hold on a second, sixth, fifth, fourth, third, second, and you got neutral in between second and first. Okay, let's try stopping again. Stop sign there, we're starting to brake. Clutch in, kick down to fifth, release. Clutch in, kick down to fourth, release. Notice we're in fourth, still moving. Now I'm almost stopped. I keep kicking down until I see neutral. Now I'm in first. Here we go. Second. Third. Fourth. Fifth. Six. That was a cool corner. Taking these corners on this bike, look at that sign. All motorcycle riders love that sign. Taking the corners on this bike is easy, you just kind of lean it. When you first get a bike, go somewhere where no one's at. Carry your cell phone with you in case you crash. But go somewhere where no one's at and get, you know, move that bike around. Get the feel of it. Move it left to right like this. Make sure there's no cop behind you. He's going to think you're drunk. Got a train coming through here. Hopefully I don't get the railroad tracks because I'm going to be turning right up here. I got to get gas. We're going to run out. When you're riding on a street like this where people can pass, stay a little bit to the right so they can see you. Don't, obviously this goes without saying. Now we have railroad tracks here. This is very weird. See the corner, the little signs right here? But we have railroad tracks while you're going around a corner. So I'm going to slow it down a bit. Standing on the pegs. Notice I'm standing up on the pegs. Good thing to do when you're going over the railroad track. And now I'm going to see if I can find a gas station here. Okay, we got a 35 mile per hour corner. What's wonderful about the 250, notice that you can just ride the line. Another 35 mile per hour corner. This thing just handles epically. Another reason why you want to have perfect tire pressure. We got a little sharp corner here to the right. Sometimes people cross this thing. You know, it's really weird too, and certain motorcycle tires are better than other tires. So we got a 25 mile per hour corner. We're even giving a little bit of throttle. We're going to downshift to fifth here. We got a real sharp corner to our right. It's more like almost a 50 mile per hour corner. It's more like almost a complete stop. So what I'll do, see how there's no traffic there? See I'm on the left side of the corner, just kind of showing you kind of cut and try to straighten it like that. Six. Remember, you're on the outside and then you cut in. you're getting a motorcycle and you're kind of heavy set, you don't want to get a Ninja 250 because it's a very light bike. The one I'm on right now doesn't have a lot of power though. But if you ride it up there on the high end of the tack, it is a screamer. It's a lot of fun. Notice it doesn't have explosive power where you're off the light, you know, and you're just the streets rushing past. But it's a blast to ride. There's a saying in the motorcycle world, and I never understood what it meant till I rode a 600, a liter bike. I've ridden different types of motorcycles. I had a ZX-10. I have a 600. I'm borrowing this bike now. I had a lot of 600s. Suzuki. I had a 1000, SV-1000. But they say it's more fun to ride like a smaller bike, like a 250 bike, a slow bike. We'll call it slow. It's more fun to ride a slow bike fast than a fast bike slow. And it really is true. But if you're a new rider, I strongly recommend the Ninja 250, which is what we're on now. And this is coming from someone I've ridden liter bikes and all the different bikes. I'm not talking about the old school Ninjas. I'm talking about at least get like a 2000, probably 9 or 8, you know, where they change the body style. And then if you're getting a Ninja, get a 250R. It's better than just the regular 250. Like we're on a 250R. They what they did is they messed around with the power band a bit and they made it to where it really handles well, and it has more of that power for freeway riding. Don't forget, go below this video and you can see our comparison where I ride a 600. You can see my old ZX-10 and my SV. You can see all those bikes and use your own judgment. Now, if you're going freeway riding, oh, that SV was awesome because it was it had a V-twin. That thing had so much torque. I mean, it would not even break a sweat on the freeway. You couldn't even get that thing to redline unless you really got on it. It had so much power, so much torque. Now, if you think you're going to be riding for a long time and you're going to be taking it serious, I would not start on a 250. I would actually start on a 600 as long as you're not, you know, getting like an R6 or some type of racing bike. Look at our comparison where I compared the 250 versus the 600 below this video. Who knows, I might put an annotation on this video that you can click. And one of the things too, I might as well tell you, some bikes, when you're going to put gas in, I mean, this is, some of the other motorcycle riders are probably going to be laughing because everyone knows this, but I didn't know it when I first started. You know how you have the nozzle of the gas pump and you have the metal inside the plastic nozzle? You got to pull the plastic back and hold it. I think there's a gas station over here. You have to kind of hold the nozzle back of the, well, there's a gas station here. Let's see if I can show you, okay? When you're getting gas, let's see if I can do this. Let's do this. Let's go over here. I just want to show this to you. So for those of you that are new, because you know you need to get gas, you don't just get the nozzle and put it in there like how you do a car. Some bikes, it takes two hands. You have to hold. Dang it. Oh, good. I could do a U-turn here because there's a gas station back there where I wanted to go. You have to hold the nozzle back. Well, I'll show you while you're getting gas. Otherwise, it... Oh, wait, we got the green arrow. All right. I put my foot down. So now I'm going to show you. I'm going to need two hands to do this, so I'm not actually going to put gas in with the camera. I'll have to set the camera down to put gas in, but I'm just going to show you. Let's do this over here. Let's go over here so people don't ask, why is he talking to himself? People hear me talking and they're like, what's he doing? Okay, so let me show you something. Here's what you gotta do, watch. So what you do, see this nozzle here like this, this plastic? You kinda hold this. Let's see. So this says $27.35. This thing will probably take like $10, $10 to $15 tops. But what you do is, you don't just go like this and put it in, right? You have to hold this back. You pull this way, like this, like that, and you hold it, and then the gas will come out. And it's good not to overfill it. Just kind of fill it where it's coming right to the top. Notice it says never fill the tank so fuel level rises into filter neck. If tank is overfilled, heat may cause fuel to expand and flow into evaporative emission control system, resulting in hard starting and engine hesitation. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. What did we learn? When you're gonna stop, keep the handlebars straight. You can get one of these things, you can put your cell phone in it, and that way you can use your GPS and all that other good stuff. If you're gonna be starting off on a new motorcycle, I strongly recommend this one, the Epic Ninja 250R. It is a blast to ride. You got the fuel gauge here. That's how I knew I was running on fuel. Some bikes don't even have a fuel gauge. You have to kind of reset the trip odometer to know when you're running out. You got the speedometer here, and you have the tach here, oil pressure here, neutral light, turn signals, brights. You got the starter here. Here's the turn signals here. You turn this left, turn this right here to the left, and it turn, the signal goes left. You have the horn, it won't honk because I have it off. You have the right turn signal, and the way you shut the turn signal off, see how it says off, you push in and it shuts it off. This is the carburetor. This is actually a carbureted bike. So I appreciate you guys watching, and you have a great week.